We are 76 out of 97 achievements deep. Pretty pristine cut, of course. So... we had just finished the nightmare route. So I'm gonna go just kind of down the list. I think. Oh wow, actually there's quite a few of the witch, but I mean, okay, we'll do another witch first. There are still quite a few. Well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's still 6 with the witch and there's like 2 with everybody else, so. Go for past light life gambit. Our later save.
You make your way up the short path to the cabin. You'll find the princess.
Shut up.
The interior of the cabin.
Without the knife, okay.
The door to the basement.
Oh, my.
Wait, really?
Only making this more difficult.
When he throws the kniff.
I'll be here. Good luck.
We kill her.
You make your way to the bottom of the stairs. Without hesitation, bring. Though your nerves are seizing with pain.
Aww.
You steel your resolve and take.
Okay.
A warning.
We've got the opportunist with us this time. Yeah, I know. Always. I always want to make it more difficult for the narrator. Okay, this time.
You take the blade from the shelf.
The knife. Not a blade. A knife.
The door to the basement creaks.
Hello.
I recognize that voice as easily as I
Yeah, I don't want to hurt you, but there's some broken trust. Take this as a gesture of my goodwill.
You can't be serious.
I'm serious.
Now, hold on. We should put this to a vote. The blade is one of our most valuable assets. We can't just give it to her. What if she uses it to kill us? I vote no. As do I. I abstain? You abstain? She's going to kill us if we give it to her.
Isn't it a democracy? We're giving her the blade.
You're going to get everyone killed. You know that, right? But of course you do.
You toss the blade at the princess's feet. She eyes it with suspicion before kneeling down to pick it up.
I wouldn't have done that. Why did you?
You hear a clanging of metal against the dirt floor and the chains fall from the princess's wrist.
She could have gotten out of those the whole time. That sneaky little...
A woman after my own heart. It's a shame we just gave her a weapon, because if I were her, I'd use it on us right now. Luckily for us, you're not her. Oh, we sure think alike, though. I can promise you that. Whatever you say next, you better make it count.
She creeps forward, taking one cautious step at a time until you and she are face to face.
What do you think happens now?
I get fucking stabbed. That's up to you. That's why I gave you the blade. I chose last time and I regret it. And now it's your time to choose.
Her shoulders tense and her eyes dart away.
This is another trick. You're trying to sow doubt, but it's not going to work on me.
And then she buries the blade in your heart.
What? No. No, come on, that's not right. I told you
this is what she was going to do. Glee dances across her face as you fall to the ground.
I did it. I got you. You.
The princess seems to tremble, her smile fading quickly, replaced with concern. Her nervous eyes brim with tears.
Why? Why did you let me do this?
But you don't have the strength to respond, nor do you have the time. Everything goes dark, and you die.
Past life gambit, hand your power to a suspicious character.
You're on a path in the woods.
She stabbed us. She actually stabbed us. Of course she stabbed us. We gave her the blade, which, I might add, I voted against. But the whole point was that she wasn't supposed to do that. The whole point of giving her the blade was to break the cycle of violence, and she just killed us anyway.
I guess it really doesn't matter if she killed us though, right? We're back here, which means that everything's fine, or fine adjacent. Maybe she won't be as keen to betray us this time. We've already proven to her that we can change. Maybe that's all it'll take to show her that there's another way to do things.
I'm so sorry if you guys heard that.
You know, maybe you're right. In which case, I suppose the only thing to do is to get back to the cabin and give it another try.
Give what another try, exactly? You are aware I've been listening to you, right? Like that changes anything. We all know the game is rigged. It doesn't even matter if she's nice this time. I'm sure he'll find a way to turn us against each other.
Fair.
Great, so you've obviously been here before, since you apparently died at least once.
Twice, actually.
Sure. Twice. Then I'll spare you the little introduction I had planned. You already know about the princess, and clearly you already know that she's dangerous. So don't muck this up. It's bad enough that this isn't your first time through.
Happens if we just leave.
She gets out is what happens. Maybe not right away, but eventually. And a world that's doomed tomorrow is just as bad as a world that's doomed today.
I'm not sure I buy that. Everything has to end eventually. If it takes years to get out of there and supposedly end the world, then we've bought everyone that time, and all without having to murder anybody in the process. Not that she's innocent, but murder is unpleasant and risky. It could be a better solution for everyone.
You're here to permanently end the threat she poses. You're not here to temporarily postpone it.
You chose to think for herself.
Yes. Good. Playing both sides. That's what smart people do, and you're the smartest in the room. I'm not sure it counts as playing both sides if people can hear you doing it. Buddy, you're thinking in far too few dimensions. There's layers to doing this right, and I'm pretty sure the one making the choices gets that.
Trust in the plan. Trust in what plan?
The decider's plan. Sure, we don't know what the plan is yet, but that's part of the whole trusting thing, isn't it? A good leader knows how and when to keep things secret, and sometimes a good leader even knows to keep things secret from himself.
Sure, we'll see what she has to say for herself, but don't forget that whatever she says is likely just as much lies as what he's been telling us. We should keep our cards close to our chest.
If I were you, I'd remember what she's done. You know how dangerous she is. And you should know that someone like her shouldn't be let loose upon the world. It isn't long before you find yourself at the base of the cabin.
I think it's clear where everyone stands at this point.
I don't know if I'd say everyone. You talking about me? I have a position. It's a good one, too.
Ignore him. He's just talking for talking's sake. My position is the only one that matters. The princess is a threat to you. She's a threat to me, and most importantly, she's a threat to the world. You know what you have to do. The interior of the cabin is hardly an interior at all anymore. The burned-out ruins merely suggest the shape of the structure that once stood here, charred wood still reeking of ash. But beneath it lies the fresh smell of spring growth after rain, the promise of new life in the wreckage of the old.
There's no knife.
The only furniture of note is the crisp shell of what was once a table. A pristine... Wait, this isn't right? This is supposed to be a pristine blade. Why isn't there a pristine blade? We gave it to her last time. She can't still have it, can she? Well, it's not here. And if she has it, let me guess, you want to get all chummy with her. Look, as far as I see it, if it's between him and her, I say we side with the one who has the weapon. It's just the smart thing to do. I wouldn't be so hasty. I'm sure the blade will turn up somewhere. She can't have it. That's not how this is supposed to work.
Of course we don't get to make a choice about the blade. Every single time we come back here, something has to be different.
You step forward and approach the scorched entryway leading to the basement, hesitating before you begin the descent.
Might as well take a look while we can. There's nothing else to do here now that the knife has been taken from us.
You reach forward and wave your hand through the hollow entrance leading to the basement. What are you doing?
Figures. Well, seems like the only way to go is forward, isn't it?
Yes, that's where everything tends to be. Let's just put on a good face and have our wits about us. You step through the frame of scorched wood and make your way into the darkness below. The stairs to the basement are covered in a fine layer of gritty ash. The air still feels warm, as if the fires that ruined this place had only recently been extinguished. Yet fresh shoots of thorny branches are already weaving themselves through the soot-covered earth of the walls around you. Their spines point courteously down towards the basement, so you're able to brush past their jagged points with ease, at least on the way down. But you don't need to think about the way back up just yet. That's a matter for after the world's been saved.
I'd say this feels like a trap, but you practically said as much. Yet you still want us to keep going.
They're only thorns. I'd say getting a few scratches in exchange for the lives of everyone in existence is a fair trade. I'm sure you'll manage. Her voice, worn down by pain and suspicion, hobbles up the stairs.
I can't get away from you, can I? We kill each other and you come back. You let me kill you and you come back. I don't know why you let me do that. I don't know what you want from me.
I don't know what I want. I never really chose to come here.
I think you know how this goes. I'm down here and I can't leave. So come down and talk. It's not like I can stop you.
You continue down the basement stairs, brushing past the smooth edges of thorns that grow more and more plentiful as you make your way forward. You step out into what was once a vast open cavern, now overrun by briars and prickles and thistles, the space thick with hostile vegetation.
Oh, gosh.
At the heart of it all, encased in a tight weave of vines, is the princess, her bloody, trembling hands clutching a pristine blade.
Did you know this was going to happen to me? Are you here to watch me suffer? Are you here to laugh?
You're in a prison of your own making.
Do you really think you can just wash your hands of all of this?
Abandon
Do you really think you can just leave me here?
Abandon her in her own prison.
This is even better than stabbing her. The same reward without any of that nasty effort.
It
it's not even better. Putting off a choice is always worse than making a committed decision, especially when you already know the right answer.
Almost feels like we're as bad as the powers that be. Is that all it really took to twist us into yet another tyrant? A single ounce of control?
It sure feels like it. She looks so sad, bleeding and alone. And we're just turning our back on her.
Oh, stop trying to bring morality into this. There are winners in life and there are losers, and what matters is that right now, we've decided to be a winner.
But as you approach the basement stairs, you make a grim realization. The thorns won't let you leave.
We don't have any way to cut through them.
Okay, new plan. We re-befriend the princess, get the blade, and all of us leave here together as friends.
You can't leave without me, can you? Isn't that funny? Isn't that so funny? This is perfect, actually. Just you and me rotting down here forever, together. You know, just to make sure things are a little more permanent, I think I'm going to take this particular needle out of the picture.
She wouldn't.
It's only fair. We were going to leave her with no way out. She's returning the kindness.
Thorns slice into the princess's hands, lacerating what little skin remains as she raises the blade to her mouth.
Oh dear.
Take it now, before she swallows it out of spite.
Yeah, don't do that.
You rush towards the princess, arms outstretched and grasping for the blade. But as you tear through her thistled prison, the thorny vines dig deep into your arms, seemingly growing thicker and sturdier the closer you get to your goal. It feels like it should be within reach, yet you cannot reach it quickly enough.
It's no use. Even if we grab it, we won't be able to pull it back out of there.
It's better than letting her eat it and losing it forever.
You just manage to reach her hand, grasping it firmly in yours before the thorns finally trap you in place. Blood trickles down your arm, mingling with hers. The two of you lock eyes.
Just unlocked trust issues. As well.
We're stuck like this, aren't we? I knew this was always going to be how it ended.
Did not think I could get trust issues as well.
She's gone.
And there's that.
But it feels so bad. Like looking into it right.
If they think it's bad.
Okay. If you say so.
Finally!
This is the thorn.
Flickering lights in empty city. This one yearns for connection she feels she doesn't deserve. Even when shown compassion, she hid herself away. She will make for a cautious heart. Do not mourn her. She isn't alone anymore. I await your return.
And a thorny vessel. Bring the thorn to her. Okay, wow. We just got 4 achievements in one go. Past life gambit, a thorny vessel, abandonment, trust issues. So now we only have 2 left on the witch route. That could potentially be done in one or are 2 different. But now there's 3 left in adversary. So we'll go with adversary. I mean, she's part of the witch, which is one of the pillars. You were saying? The witch is like one of people's favorites. I'll have to see her other routes because the other two also have to do with the thorn. Gonna go for I didn't hear no bell.
you make your way up. The interior of the cavern.
You take the.
The door to.
In on you.
Oh, it's been so long since anyone's come down here. I was starting to think they'd forgotten about me.
I'm not here to kill you.
That giant.
You ignore the trembling.
And.
Doubt on. You and the princess stare at.
Adversary. Okay. Gavin?
A warning. The cabin is.
Nope. We enter without
the
blade. No
knife this time.
And we attack her unarmed.
I guess we'll have to see how this goes. Your hands empty, you charge the princess. Quit the pessimism, will you? Right? It's almost like you don't want us to beat her. No, look, I'm rooting for you, I really am. I'm just doing my best to keep my expectations grounded. You don't have a weapon. You're supposed to have a weapon.
We'll be fine. Just watch.
You attack, fists raised, and the two of you fall into combat. Your clawed fingers tear into her flesh, and her fists and elbows return the blows in kind, bruises blossoming in her wake, and blood vessels rupturing in vivid sprays of gore.
Not bad. You're tougher than I thought you'd be.
Hear that? She respects us. We can pull this off.
Yeah. Yeah. You're right.
But without that knife, you'll never be enough.
Her knee connects with your sternum with a loud, violent crack. The wind leaves your lungs, and as you struggle for breath, you can feel something flooding in to fill the space.
Ugh.
Hot blood, suffocating you from the inside.
You have to want to kill me. Like this.
You don't so much as see her movement before she deals the killing blow. Everything goes dark, and you die.
Are you serious? That's it?
No way. Stubborn's not gonna let that happen.
That's it.
Like hell it is.
Yep.
We're not giving up that easy. Now get up.
Didn't you hear me? You're dead. There's no getting up from that.
Up.
Wait, no, that's not right. You're
not dead anymore.
Yes. Your eyes bolt open and you push yourself back to your feet. You're alive. The princess takes a step back and looks down at her pulp-covered fists.
I could have sworn I killed you. That's your face splattered on the walls and dripping from my hands.
Ugh. Gross.
The two of you clash once more. It's not as one-sided as I feared, but it's still a far cry from what I'd hoped. Her injuries, though numerous, pale in comparison to yours, and the wounds you've inflicted upon her barely seem to have slowed her down. As much as you're trying to ignore it, adrenaline pushing you far past your limits, every movement burns.
This is getting boring. Are you even trying to keep up with me?
She lands another devastating... no. Lethal blow. Everything goes dark. Again. And you die. Again.
You know what I'm going to say.
Stubborn is so metal.
Though we're not dead.
Yeah. Though we're not dead. Come on, get up. If we can just keep going, we're bound to wear her down eventually.
Are you sure she can't do what we're doing right now?
There's only one way to find out.
Once more, you push yourself back to your mangled feet.
How are you still moving? How are you still doing anything?
That low growl from which of them? The stubborn?
Bodies aren't supposed to look like that.
Oh, that has some very fucked up implications.
An uncharacteristic terror seems to grip her voice.
Yeah, probably because we just look like a pulpy mass.
Have we ever seen her afraid before?
Not really. The stubborn? Yeah, he's pretty metal.
No, we haven't. This is how we win. We can do this forever.
I'm going to put you out of your misery. I don't like looking at you like this. You're all twitching and wrong.
Also, I love how the turns have tabled in this version. Have you seen this version before?
I'd like to see her try. We're invincible.
Her fist flies towards where your face used to be, your twisted body incapable of moving out of the way. And then you see nothing.
Everything goes dark and we die.
Yes, something like that.
I heard the ghost.
Well, don't you have something to say?
Yeah, I quit.
What? I didn't hear no bell. Put your foe unarmed and go the distance.
You're on a path in the woods, and at the end of that path...
All right, change of plans. We're taking the blade this time.
Okay.
Now, why would we ever do that? Because she absolutely destroyed us? She sure did, but what a great way to go.
Does it matter? We lost.
Oh, why so glum, Rage? Boy, I thought you were brave. I thought you were proud. Was all that bravado just hot air?
Look, it was just... The fight was better the first time, and the first time we had a weapon.
Bubba? I'm Bubba.
Sorry, I just saw my cat's head peek up on the other side of the desk. I was like, what the fuck?
This is just great. Let me cut to the chase. Clearly, you've already been here.
Good.
The interior of the cabin is a place that feels long forgotten. There was once an elegance to its construction.
You may have seen us
carved marble columns
fighting
holding a high arched roof. Vault.
Shut the fuck up. Okay. Fighting the adversary to the point where we freaked her out and she mercy killed us. Because we were literally just a pulpy mess.
You step forward and approach the door. You bring your fist crashing down against the door leading to the basement.
You tend to weakly claw your fingers across my skin, or have you finally decided to try and kill me properly?
I think you'll find it won't be so simple. I've changed. The way your flesh felt grinding beneath my fist, it woke something in me. That wasn't a fight. It was something worse. I'm something worse now. Why don't you come down and see what you've made of me?
All the flesh here makes a lot of sense with the fact that we were a pulpy mess.
Do you hear that? Well, sounds like we got to her last time. Let's keep pushing, see what else we can make happen.
You make your way to the bottom of the stairs. The chamber's walls are painted in blood, a deep, sickening red that drips down in clotted streams onto the charred. Still unarmed, you charge towards the princess.
It's now or never. Let's make it a beautiful blaze of glory.
With a horrifying squelch.
Yeah, you are unarmed. That's the only way that ever ends.
This... Yeah, don't look at it. I don't like that thing.
Screw the mirror. We just need to find the princess.
Yeah, you bloated. Are you withered? Okay. So, I'm going to load from a first... Well, let me keep going, but I don't think I get anything for this.
I will be...
Yeah, okay. Load. And this is from a first out.
Okay, so that was I didn't hear no bell. And the next on my list is back to the damsel route. And I think we're gonna get the last three for the damsel.
You make your way up the
It seems like they all have the same one. We'll see.
The interior of the cabin is almost entirely
without the knife. But yeah,
the door to
Katie, the romantic haze, the one that was like the good one for the smitten, that's the most popular route people have gotten. That's the one with the most achievements. Hi, baby. Hi. What are you doing here so early?
How many times do I have to tell you?
Wow. Katie's like, no, I want conflict with the Eldritch wife. I saw something online that was like, isn't this just a super toxic relationship? I'm like, they're gods. When is it ever not toxic? Even Hades and Persephone, because Persephone turns mint into a mint plant. That's very fucking toxic, Percy.
Only making this more diff-
Okay.
You make your way to the bottom of- Fine. No, we won't- Stop that.
Also tell stories about toxic relationships when people recognize them. Damn, that's my whole problem with the new Harley Quinn that's super popular, is that it's like she knows the Joker is bad and so she's with Ivy instead. And I'm like, no, don't make that the mainline story. Bruce Timm and Paul Dini created Harley as part of a narrative to try to warn people about very horribly manipulative relationships. Please.
The blade. Move the...
Like, again, I don't mind Harley and Ivy, but like, as a mainline story, it bothers me. Because there's like a new Joker love interest where it's like, she's gonna fight Harley Quinn. They're gonna see who's good enough for the Joker's love. And I'm like, that's just not how that works. This is stupid. And like, the Joker like stalked her and like, hid in her like closet at her dorm and shit. It was so weird and just not in character for the Joker either. It was weird. I hated it. I was like reading about it and I'm like, I hate this. I just legitimately hate this. The Harley and Joker story is a classic.
A warning. The interior. You take the blade from the table. It would be difficult to slay the princess and save the world without a weapon.
But speaking of toxic,
I suppose if we're to play the role of dashing knight, we need an equally dashing sword. That way she'll know we can defend her from her enemies.
Hopefully it doesn't put her on edge. There's no use arguing over motivations right now. It's good that you took the blade. You'll need it to do your job. The door to the basement creaks open.
blade in hand, you run the princess down.
Wait, no! You barbarian, what do you think you're doing?
But you ignore the pleas of the foolish little voice and press on. The princess's eyes grow wide with terror as you approach, but she does absolutely nothing to stop you. Your blade pierces her heart, and she collapses pathetically to the ground.
He sounds way too happy about this.
I'm sorry, did I do something wrong?
No, my love, you did nothing wrong. I'm sorry, not you!
Oh, I'm sorry, Smitten.
I'm going to die now. I think that's what you want.
Ah, see, no, that's so fucked up. Ah, she just only cares about what we want.
And just like that, she's dead. And the world is saved. Thank you for seeing this through. I know it must have been difficult.
Lady Killer, slay an innocent. Katie's so happy.
I feel sick.
Yeah, that was pretty fucked up.
Sick? You took part in the murder of the fairest creature that's ever lived. And you merely feel sick? I, for one, am absolutely distraught. Grief-stricken. Inconsolable.
I should not be laughing, but his voice cracked on sick. And you merely feel sick?
You'll get over it. You just saved everyone.
Get over it?
Oh.
You smarmy ass. Ooh. There's nothing in the world worth getting over it for. We might as well just end it all.
You raise the blade, aiming the point directly towards your hut. Excuse me? No, you absolutely do not do that. Yeah, let's not make any rash decisions. We should give ourselves a minute, take a deep breath, and
rash. The only rash decision we've made was running our cursed blade through her heart. This is far from rash. This is measured. This is the only thing left for us to do now that she's gone.
I'm the one who makes the decisions here, and I say no.
Exactly. You're not doing this.
All of you may have previously thought that my passions were too great to stifle, but those were merely passions of joy. My passions of sorrow run deeper than the ocean itself, and you'll find that they are far more unstiflable.
Oh, Shakespearean.
Haven't you? Haven't you all?
Help me, he's Shakespearean, and he's a fucking thespian. Characters that are thespian either go one of two ways. I hate them, or I find them hilarious and charming.
I don't believe this.
Looking at you, fucking... Xehanort's heartless.
What? What don't you believe?
Fucking Billy Zane in the first Kingdom Hearts makes him such a thespian.
You plunge the blade into your own heart and collapse to the floor. You can't be serious. Why are you helping him? I'm not. He just made it happen. I'm sorry.
Yeah, he does have more power than the narrator.
That's right. You're all sorry.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah, the Seeker of Darkness. Thank you. For some reason, I kept thinking the Wise, and I'm like, that's not the right Ansem.
Everything goes dark, and you die.
And I kept thinking Bitch Ansem, and I'm like, that's my nickname for him. My very affectionate nickname for him, but that's my nickname for him. The Gray. Yep. Yeah, we're getting even weirder.
You're
here.
You're on a path in the woods.
You horrid monster. Ooh. Do you think just because we've returned to the woods you've earned my forgiveness? Our beloved had best be alive and well when we return to the cabin, or you'll never know the end of my wrath.
She won't be alive and well when we return to that cabin, because she's dead. We killed her.
You killed her, and so I killed you.
And you clearly didn't do a good enough job. I'm still here.
Oh, and I'm still here too. If you lot get to be blessed with seemingly eternal life, that must mean she's still there, waiting for us to throw ourselves at her feet in remorse.
I doubt it. I think I'm better at killing than you are.
So you've been here before. Of course you've been here before. What count?
It's our third.
Your open discussion.
I couldn't care less what he knows. Every second we stand around arguing in the woods is a second that I'm anxiously worrying about her. Take us to the cabin and take us there now. With each passing moment, our relationship may be damaged even further. Though I fear the rift between us may already be permanent.
And if it is permanent, then what? You'll kill us again.
Oh, you just wait and see.
Jesus!
My vengeance will echo the depths of my bereavement.
Don't provoke him. I'd prefer if we didn't die again. I'm not fond of dying.
Why not? You've already done it twice.
It was unpleasant.
It was only unpleasant because you think it's supposed to be unpleasant.
I'll make you feel what I feel if it's the last thing I do. And mark my words, you won't like it when it happens.
I don't think we will.
Oh, how exciting. I'd love to see you try.
Can I?
Well, I'm not just going to try. I'm going to actually do it.
I'm looking forward to it.
Oh, this is what happens when you fucking, when you challenge, like, the Narmi character to actually step up. He's gonna step up. I'm actually putting my money on the Smitten right now.
Good. I am too.
Can I talk now? Yes, I can. Great. Now that you're listening, let me remind you that if you're here in the woods, it means that the princess is not dead, and that her very existence currently poses a direct threat to the entire world.
No one in charge here, and if we slay her again, you are not going to kill her, make us kill ourselves. Is that clear?
Oh, it's clear, you murderer. Though I should remind you that you're not as in charge as you seem to think you are.
I'm sure his outburst last time was just a fluke. I wouldn't worry about it. Besides, if he kills us again, he kills us again. It doesn't matter. He'll tire out eventually. The flame of passion always burns out in the end.
What about the flame of hatred?
Spoken like a true cynic.
Enough bickering. Just stay focused and get to the cabin. I'm sure you've already heard my words of warning.
Oh, we'll muck it up all right. We'll get our happy ending, even if it damns each and every person who's ever lived.
Whatever you do, don't let him influence a single decision. He's clearly lost it. I hate that I'm agreeing with him on anything, but I really don't like being at the whims of someone so unstable. It's stressful.
Yes. Having all those feelings isn't very productive, is it? But we're just passengers here. Why stress over something you can't control?
I can't decide which I think is more fun, when voices are in accord with each other or when they're really not. They're all fucking scary in their own way. Except for the broken. He's just fucking annoying.
You're saying that like stress is just something you can turn off.
I wish.
It is. It's easy. Whatever happens, happens.
Oh, cold. Please tell that to my lifetime of anxiety.
Are you even alive? What's the point of doing anything if you're not going to feel a single emotion?
I don't know. I just exist. And that's fine with me.
This is horribly unproductive. The cabin...
The interior,
yeah, I was
going to
say we've been here before.
Brittle. Ancient dust-covered wooden beams hold up a crumbling ceiling like mummified ribs, each elegantly carved detail of the stately building preserved in an extended stasis. Everything here has been kept safe and dry and lifeless.
Yeah, this is when we drowned last time. Last time we were down here, we drowned.
But you're not alone. You can feel something watching you. There is a figure faintly outlined against the dusty wood of the far wall.
Is that her? Our beloved. So she does live.
Bro, that's a ghost.
She doesn't look very alive to me.
Before you can make a move, the figure is gone.
The door at the end of the mirror?
Huh.
Maybe it's gone. Perhaps it's gone because
an oh-so-deserved guilt has started to worm
its
way into each and every one of you. Perhaps all of you do feel just as bad as I about what we've done. Though if you felt the oppressive guilt I feel, we would have manifested that weapon directly into our heart. I suppose it doesn't matter why the blade is gone. You make your way to the... It's so hazy. It's time for all of you to see what we've become. You reach forward and place your hand on the door. So much for our reflect. I see. We are too hideous for even a mirror to behold. We can only hope she might still see some good in us. No way left to go but down.
I'm sure she's not going to. I think she's
pissed. The door to the basement creaks open, revealing an antique staircase lit by weak torchlight. The air here is so stale it practically stands still, as if the very molecules of this place have been fossilized, trapped for eons until your arrival. Even the blaze of the torches can't penetrate the odorless air, as if they'd run out of fuel to burn ages ago, their light still flickering more out of habit than from adhering to a physical reality. A wispy figure watches you from the bottom of the stairs, face veiled in shadow.
There she is again.
My love. She's just an old memory. Your eyes lock for a brief moment.
There?
You receive no response.
Do you think she's... Of course she's livid. And with good reason.
I mean, he's right. We fucking stabbed her in the heart.
You aren't helping.
Are you scared of a little ghost?
Bro, ghosts can do a lot. Sorry, Cole.
As you descend the final step, the form of the princess comes into view. A skeletal body lying in a heap on the floor, her wrist still bound to the wall by a heavy chain. This cell is a dark and isolated place. See?
No! What foul trickery is this? How can this be? We just saw her alive and well a moment ago, floating away transparently.
That was a ghost.
Whatever we saw was a ghost. Thought we were all on the same page.
Do try to keep up.
Your thoughts are interrupted by the sound of a slamming door and a clicking lock. You turn to see the shade of the princess staring down at you from the top of the stairs, clutching a brightly burning torch.
It's very wooden
so
down
that's
here.
That's where the blade is. It's already in her heart. And yet she isn't dead.
No, she's very dead.
She is dead. Have you...
Oh, for the love of... Can...
Yeah, dead or not, we make amends. She obviously still holds us in her heart. She's bearing a torch for us and everything.
Smitten.
But she hasn't said anything.
You came back. I missed you.
That angelic voice. I missed you too, my beloved.
It's in every Minecraft player with a woodhouse ever. Oh my god. You build with wood in Minecraft and you're just asking to die. You are asking to lose everything.
You sure snapped back to your old self quick.
Yes. Seeing her dazzling countenance again has reignited the warmth in my heart. I have found it in me to forgive the sins this body has committed. We can have our perfect romance after all.
Oh, I don't think we can. My poor brother and his three-story woodhouse that got hit by lightning after- Yup, exactly. It does not matter if you, make that creeper-free, lava-free, whatever. Lightning can and will hit it eventually.
This is a bad place. We're supposed to be together, but it keeps making us hurt each other.
The torch falls from the princess's hand and bounces down the stairs.
It'll be so much better when it's gone.
The skeletal wood of the basement, perfectly dry after uncountable years of desiccation, immediately catches fire.
She's trying to kill us.
Yes, she is.
A misplaced escalation of her passions, but clearly she still cares for us. I say we burn with her.
I'm gonna burn. Rush for the door.
As you rush up the stairs, the entire cabin erupts into a raging inferno. You ignore the princess, throwing yourself headlong against the door, bashing at it with your clenched fists in a vain attempt at freedom. It's no use. You're stuck here. Your skin starts to bubble. As layers of you peel away into raw, seeping burns, you feel a hand on yours. You turn to see the princess, face bright and smile wide with manic affection. She clutches you close to her chest, watching with loving eyes as the flames eat you away, bit by bit. The pain is unbearable at first. Every inch of you screams as your flesh is stripped away, your muscles stiffening as they're cooked, your blood boiling in your veins. But it isn't long before the flames take your nerves, and with them, your ability to feel much of anything.
Oh, God! I knew you'd like this, Katie. I saw these as like the last couple of achievements, and I'm like, Katie's gonna like these.
See? That wasn't so bad.
I beg to differ, Cole. That is nasty.
It was so bad.
But somehow, nothing is so much worse.
You'll get used to it.
There are still the feelings of the heart. Those never go away.
Oh, they always do in the end. You just haven't experienced enough. Eventually you'll want them to stop too. You'll make them stop. Trust me.
The princess's smile never fades. Her skin peels away, and then her muscle, until all you can see is her charring skull, locked in an eternal grin.
It's very romantic, really. We got our happy ending after all. We can die happy.
Burning down the house, burned the hands of something vessel. And that's how we're gonna get the burning vessel, or the burned gray, burning gray. But despite your best efforts, you do not die, and she is gone.
She's gone. And there's that mirror. There's something dreadful.
Yes, I fear that we won't like what we'll see. What if we just sit here and preen for a while? That can't hurt, right?
Ignore the cowards. You have to look.
I'm begging you. It's different now. It feels...
Something finds me. Yes. Nerves, and this one is passion betrayed. But even in the end, her love never faded. She will make for a bright heart. Do not mourn her. She has served her purpose. Nothing, and she asks.
Burning vessel, bring the burned gray to her. And that is the damsel route done. So we have finished the damsel, nightmare, razor, and stranger. And of course, every story related. So we have a Spectre, Tower, Witch, Prisoner, adversary and beast, which I did skip over beast. So what's next on beast? You can't keep this up forever. And light. I don't know if there we'll get them in the same swoop or no, but we'll say hello to the hunted again.
The interior.
Okay. You can't keep them forever. Without the knife.
The door to the basement.
Do not tell her that you're here to save her. Getting in on you.
You are?
When he throws the knife, I'm just leaving the princess thinking about.
Only making the.
Okay.
You make your way to the. Without hesitation, though your nerves are seizing. Are you serious? A warning. The interior of the cabin is ruinous and dilapidated. It feels like no one has lived here for a long time.
Sounds like you said you make your way to the butt. I'm five. Okay, enter the basement without the knife. Move and chat until you can survive, then run for the stairs. Repeat this process several times.
No steel claw.
You touched the butt. I can't believe you made me say that.
There's a shift in the humid air, and something enormous.
Oh, I fucked up.
Princess, she is too quick to outrun, too nimble to-
I fucked up. We'll just reload from the beginning, it's fine. I'm no longer worried about a-
You make your way-
A timeline here. I should at least-
The interior of the camp-
Save. I get to the beast thing. The beast section.
The door to the.
You are?
But if I don't have to go through this rigmarole.
You're only make.
Okay.
You make your way to the. Without hesitation, though your nerves are seized. Are you serious?
Oh. Here we go.
The interior of the cabin is ruinous and dilapidated.
Shut up. Okay. We enter without, and then I'll save.
No steel claw. Do you- You lunge to the side, picking a direction on instinct. As you land, your butt. In an instant, she's pounced on the spot where you would have been. Hurt before you can blink, she's gone. Vanished.
You're faster than you were before. But
you whirl around to find her, so she's cut off our escape.
What do you want?
I want to swallow you whole. And I will get what I want. You have no exit. You have no hope. You live and die by my whims, and my whims alone.
Don't ask her what she wants. Just run for the blade upstairs and slay her with it. Is that all the advice you have? We don't even know what she looks like. Some specifics would be very helpful. She's just a princess. Don't overthink it. She is clearly not.
You want to kill me?
Why does anything kill anything else? She needs to.
I didn't say I wanted to kill you.
Yeah, she just said she wanted to eat us.
It sounds like she wants to do something even worse.
War is worse.
What she wants only matters if she wins, and you're not going to let that happen. She's coiling for another strike. Be somewhere else. We're on the back foot. The back foot keeps us nimble. Keeps us alive. It doesn't matter if it keeps us alive, if it eventually kills us. We need to take back the...
Did I get a possum? I have not gotten a possum. I actually have 3 left. Hang on, let me see. They did.
We're playing dead. It's unexpected. It could work. As the princess lunges from the shadows once more, you collapse to the ground, feigning death. She lands directly on top of you with her full weight, nearly crushing you into the dirt, but then... silence. Only broken by the sound of your beating heart.
Possum, fool a predator by faking your own death.
That actually worked, didn't it? Only, what do we do to make her leave? Do we just keep playing dead? She sniffs at you, shifting her weight uncomfortably as her face finds yours. Her breaths are hot and oppressive against your skin.
Have you seen my great big eyes? Because they see you, fledgling. They see your heartbeat pulsing in your throat.
That or, you know, we were gonna have to breathe.
Move! Now! But it's too late for you to move. Her...
Survive.
You spring to a new patch of jungle, barely moving out of the way before the princess surges past you with a speed that makes her practically unseen.
Run for the stairs.
Yes, now's our chance. Quick. Right, I agree. We can't do anything without a weapon. We can regroup once we're armed and try to figure out a better plan. Don't plan ahead. Act on the now. All that matters is that we stay alive. As you turn to sprint for the stairs, you feel the air shift. You instinctively glance behind you just in time to see the princess lunge from the shadows, more unhinged and dripping, eyes fierce and full of hunger. She is too quick to outrun, too nimble to outmaneuver, too determined to overpower. This is her domain. You are devoured. I guess that's it then, isn't it? Unfortunately for you, no.
Really?
This isn't. You are in a dark and coarse.
It said to repeat that process several times.
Jungle, barely moving out of the way before the princess surges past you with a speed that makes her practically unseen.
Maybe. Why do you want to eat me?
I don't question who I am or what I want. I simply do. To act is always better than to react.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but you do well to listen to her. Less standing around asking questions, more doing exactly as I say.
B was pawing at me. Do is always better than to watch.
You have to. We at least have to make an opening. A tickling sensation rises at the base of your neck. Flee. We can't keep doing this. Maybe she's a little faster. You avoid her slavering jaws, but she manages to graze you, her titanic momentum skinning you along your side. It's like being sideswiped by sandpaper. How is she that fast?
You're bleeding now.
You instinctively touch your side, testing her claim. It's wet and stings from the gentle touch of your fingertips. A costly mistake. We can't make it again. We will make it again unless something changes. We have to break the pattern. We need more time. She's cutting off our escape.
You approach and offer a snoot.
Our game is nearing its end.
Okay, this one I actually do have to make a new fucking save for every time, because...
She's right there. We have to wait for an opening. That's fair. She'll kill us if we try and run past her.
What if we helped each other?
You cannot reason your way out of this, fledgling. There's no compromise with what I am.
At least she's upfront about her intentions. She's more tense this time. She means this next blow to be the last. The mere thought of moving again makes your bloodied side ache. We're exhausted. We're bleeding. We're still alive. We owe it to ourselves to move.
Again.
Once again, you narrowly avoid the full force of the impact, and once again, you are too slow to come away unscathed. You're starting to get tired. This isn't working. We have to do something.
Mistakes.
We have to figure out a plan. Don't plan ahead. Act on the now. All that matters is that we stay alive. We're trying, but we can't keep this up much longer. We have to. We keep up or we die.
You're getting slow.
Oof.
She seizes the opportunity, lunging once again from the darkness, fangs bared and claws flashing. She attacks over and over and over, and each time she leaves with a little piece of you.
Too tired to think, but we have to think. We have to move.
It's too late. Before you get the chance to react, it's over. She makes her last foray from the dark corners of the room, unhinging her dripping maw, her eyes fierce and full of hunger. You do your best to dive out of the way, and you partially succeed.
You can't keep this up forever. Dodge a creature until you can dodge no longer. There was no running for the stairs on that guide.
Partially? Yes. The princess fails to swallow you whole.
Oh, good.
She only swallows your lower body.
Oh, good.
That's just as bad. That's worse, even. It's death either way. At least this will be a faster end.
Yeah.
You look down to see that the dirt between you is strewn with your intestines, trailing all the way up and disappearing behind her blood-stained teeth. Your legs are nowhere to be seen. You start to go into shock. The princess,
she's spaghetti
bloody
slurping
saliva
it.
Dripping from her lips, idly gnaws on what's left of you as you rapidly fade away.
Oh, she doesn't need to spaghetti slurp my intestines like a snake does to a mouse.
I didn't mean to do that. I still need to devour you. And it doesn't count if you're dead.
We're not dead,
We're dead.
But you don't have time to protest her premature observation of your death, because everything goes dark, and you die.
Yeah, no shit, but I don't do, I like body horror, but I don't do well with it. I'm very squeamish. So, I'm sorry you guys are hearing all the blends and the is, but I swear to God I'm not faking that shit.
You're
it makes my skin crawl.
That didn't work. We're going in with a plan this time. We're not getting stuck in another loop, just acting on instinct. We're stuck in a big enough loop as it is.
Instinct was keeping us alive.
Until it wasn't. So what are we supposed to do?
Great. So you've been here before.
So you know more than you're letting on.
Yeah, what he said.
Of course I do, but believe me, it's in your best interests. The more you know about the princess, the more difficult your task will be. Why is that? Having me explain why would defeat the whole purpose. There are simply some things I'm not allowed to tell you. It's a hard rule.
And whose rule is it? Who's telling you to boss us around? We've died twice already, and if you want us to stay alive this time, it's in your best interests to give us an edge.
It's my rule, and this conversation is over. You make your way down to the camp.
So, we need a plan. We've been over the plan. Go to out of the shadows. Make her show herself.
And What if she doesn't want to be seen?
The blasts are great. Do not apologize for art. This is what you get when you come to my stream. Body horror and me going, it's really good. It's super good. My brain just makes it worse. Like, this game does just enough, but it doesn't go into gore porn. Thank God. I can't stand gore porn. Like the Saw movies or like kind of gratuitous bloody scenes. I hate that shit. Like, I'm like, if there's going to be severe violence, there needs to be a purpose for it.
We'll figure out a way to make it happen.
Which is why I'm not a big Eli Roth fan.
And if that doesn't make him any easier to fight, it will. It's always easier to fight what you can see, no matter how big or toothy she might be. She spent as much time as she could in the shadows. So we're gonna draw her out.
But she's fast, and she's clever.
We're clever too. So this time we're not gonna let her cut off our escape. We're gonna lead her to the stairs ourselves. It'll be a lot easier to deal with her once we can actually see what she is.
I fell asleep during Saw. Oh my God, I could never. Stanzi Potenza has some great YouTube shorts about Saw. Like, what, like, people just would rather die than do any of Jigsaw shit because, like, health insurance is too expensive. It's so funny.
But you already know what she is. She's a princess.
Yeah, right. A princess we couldn't see, and one that had big, sharp teeth, too. How about you stick to describing things and we'll stick to doing our job?
Sharp teeth. The interior is dark and overgrown. The only furniture, the blade, is your...
If there's a way forward, that mirror is blocking it off.
What are you talking about?
He isn't tricking us. Then either way, we need to investigate. You really think being unarmed is best? I hope you know what you're doing. But let's not forget that it's up here if things go south.
The steel claw makes us sloppy, too confident. We'll be faster without it.
I love that the hunted calls it a steel claw.
You step forward.
Haven't you been paying attention? We're not hesitating. This supposed hole is blocked by that old mirror.
That mirror isn't part of the it. It's so grimy. You reach forward and wave your hand. See? Nothing. Tricks of the eye. No one sense can be trusted on its own. You step forward into the darkness. If there were once stairs leading into the... It smells of mold. As you crawl forward, stay quiet.
Okay. Remain silent.
You say nothing, maintaining the silence as you carefully make your way down into the basement. The basement is dark and cavernous, a gaping...
Stay on your toes. We take a step into the shadows, and as soon as she moves, we jump back. Make her follow. From there, we trap her in the tunnel, draw her out of the cabin, whatever it takes to get her out of her element. Then we're safe.
Step into the shadows and try and lure her out.
You step into the shadows and are enveloped in total darkness. Your heart pounds in your chest, ears pricked, eyes wide despite the inky blackness, waiting for any sign of movement.
That's right. Keep steady. Don't let your nerves get the better of you.
There. She's about to strike.
With the near silence of a determined predator, the princess erupts from the shadows.
But you've already started your swift escape.
That's stage one. Now stay focused.
You dive into the tunnel and begin scrambling up towards the cabin. You hear her behind you, claws raking at the dirt, chains rattling, breaths hot and heavy with the effort of the ascent. But the sounds are coming slower now. The breaths pained and stuttering. You no longer sense frantic motion behind you in the tunnel. You risk a glance.
We just got flight, which ends the beast route. Achievements. Successfully escape a creature from its den.
She is a broad and sickly creature, her withered and emaciated flesh clinging to bones too large to fit in the narrow space. She managed to squirm her way into the tunnel in pursuit, but now she's stuck, incapable of either moving towards you or returning to the open darkness of the basement below. So that's what she's become. She wasn't like this when we started.
Was she?
No, she wasn't.
Looking at her makes me feel sad.
Yeah, now that we can see her, she doesn't feel like much of a threat at all. Her eyes look up at yours, wide, pleading. Come back, you can imagine them saying. Don't leave me here. But you shouldn't listen to the sad eyes of a vanquished enemy. She wants nothing more than to change places with you.
If you want us to ignore her, then why would you tell us any of that wide-pleasing eyes begging for mercy business to begin with? All it does is make us feel conflicted.
That's true.
I'm merely describing things as they are. It's not my fault that her eyes had something to say, even if that something was a ploy, which, if I might stress, I pointed out to you.
No, he's enjoying it. And then he's like, oh, but it's a ploy.
What should we do about her anyway? Can she still end the world like this?
She hurts. We should help.
Maybe we should try and talk to her. This is a good opportunity for information. We shouldn't waste it.
That's a terrible idea. She doesn't know anything. She hasn't even said a word since you got here.
Ah.
You cautiously make your way closer to the princess, her eyes avoiding yours with the silent resignation of a defeated predator.
You don't get the opportunity to speak to her. You turn to see that something has taken her away and that it's left something else in her place.
She's gone.
And there's that...
There's something... That thing reeks of death.
You're right. Part of me wants the truth, but something stronger is holding me back. Fear.
Yeah, that's also something to take into the account is, like, or take into account is nearly all of the alters are afraid of it. The cold doesn't care, and neither does the stubborn. But the stubborn is just like, who gives a fuck about it? We just need to find the princess and keep fighting. But like, and the cold is like, well, we need to look into it. But everybody else is like afraid of it.
I'm begging you. It's different now. It feels...
Something. Yes. Nerve. This one is consumed by instinct. A predator pushing those around her to a nothing, as we are. There is no exit, but the bring me. She asks.
Okay. That is done. I know I could finish adversary, but let's do prisoner. Okay. I was reading.
You make your way up the short. The interior of the cabin is almost entirely.
We take the blade.
You take the blade. The door to the base. Her voice.
Who's there?
She sounds. Don't let it fool.
Oh, it's been so long since anyone's come down here.
You walk down the stairs. She's so focused on the task at hand.
And there you are. Are you here to kill me or something?
I'm not here to kill you.
That giant knife you're holding kind of gives it...
The blade! Don't you dare. It's fine.
Then we drop it.
The blade tumbled.
Thank you. Maybe now we can just talk.
Against your better will be fine. I don't know what you're hoping to accomplish here, but I can...
So here we are. What an awkward start to a relationship.
Best in the world.
Don't just tell her that.
Hoping you'd tell me.
Ending the world seems... too long.
Okay, we've talked enough.
Have you decided?
You know why you're here.
I'm in her chains.
Oh, you have to be.
Well, you do have that big, sharp.
You make your way back to the bottom of the...
And save her.
Against your better... No, we won't... Stop that. The blade. Move. A warning. She will lie. Yes, yes. Don't... Did you just say... No, I didn't.
Wink.
The interior of the cabin is
here. I believe we take the blade again. Yes.
You take the blade from the table. The door to the basement creaks open.
Sit with her.
You step towards the princess, but she stops you before you get too close.
There is fine.
That's reasonable. You do as she asks and sit on the floor.
Thank you. Yes, your intentions. You have a knife. There isn't a keyhole in these shackles.
Is she forgetting about the shackle on her neck? Or does she think she'd survive a beheading? You're right. Maybe she's... Unless she really could.
So I suppose you could just be here to kill me. But I don't think that's in either of our best interests.
How am I supposed to cut you out if you didn't notice your head is on a shackle too?
No. Like, I trust you to come any closer with that knife. All you're going to do is hand it to me and watch me work.
But she would have to cut her head off, right? She can't be suggesting that. She certainly seems confident. Maybe she knows something we don't. Or maybe you should consider the most likely scenario. She's bluffing so she can disarm you. Though if she isn't bluffing, whatever she has planned might be for her benefit alone. There's no guarantee that what's good for her is good for us.
So, what should we do?
I don't know. I'm just spelling out our options, listing the pros and cons. Then let me help you. I'll start with the cons. If you're handing her your weapon, the cons are that she might use it to escape and end the entire world, and she might use it to kill you.
That doesn't sound great. What about the pros?
There are none. The pros are that we can't trust him, possibly even more than we can't trust her. And whatever she has planned could do something to mess with what he has planned. Or maybe they're both screwing us over in their own ways.
I realize I have much reason to distrust you as you have to- No, that's very hypocritical. I'm trusting you.
Slide it over.
No, absolutely not. I am not letting you hand your only weapon over to the world-ending princess. Until you come up with any other idea, like, say, I don't know, doing your job and slaying her, you remain rigidly in place. Do you think this will work? Interesting that you're only having us remain in place. It's almost like there are very real limits to your power. I don't know what you're talking about.
The world ends if we fail, right? Her killing us might not be our only failure state, if you catch my meaning.
I don't know where you're going with this. Could you explain?
Yes, explain it.
Sure. I'm insinuating that we could kill ourselves. Ruin this whole thing.
You wouldn't.
I'm not afraid of dying. Are you?
A little.
You got your point across.
Fine. You slide the blade across the floor. The princess maintains unsettling eye contact as she reaches down to pick it up.
Thanks.
She pulls up her hair, smiling slightly, as she raises the blade to her throat. What is she doing? She doesn't say another word, as she cuts into her own neck.
No!
Her eyes stare forward, unblinking, as she soars through skin, veins, cartilage. At last she reaches bone, the blade grinding audibly against her vertebra as it continues to slice its way through her neck.
I'll be damned. She's actually doing your job for you.
Why would she do that?
Huh.
So that's her play.
Killing herself?
She isn't dead yet.
Finally, you hear a snap. Her eye twitches. There's an uneasy silence. She remains motionless for a long moment, her twitching eye the only movement in the room, until at last it stops in an unsettling half-wink. Her head twists slowly to the side, flopping to her shoulder, and her neck opens. The remaining tissue is not enough to hold the weight of her severed head. It stretches and tears until finally it falls to the floor, completely free. It bounces a few times before rolling to a stop at your feet.
Oh no, oh no, oh no, what did we do? Can we put it back? Please tell me we can put it back.
The princess's eyes stare up at you, dead.
Congratulations! You saved the world. I hate this. Can we just get out of here now, please?
Of course, the princess is slain and the world is saved. Whenever you're ready, you can proceed to your reward.
We should take her with us, don't you think?
What? No, you shouldn't do that. Why would you do that?
I can think of lots of reasons. A trophy, proof of our victory. Hell, we could even give her a proper burial. She did save the world, right?
Oh, you're good. You're not the only one who noped out. I took my headphones off. This is the one where I took my headphones off. Not being eaten alive, not drowning, not burning alive. Nothing. It was that. Nope.
You don't need proof. You don't need a trophy, and she doesn't deserve a burial. Just leave.
Even after all that, you're still not satisfied, are you? Something is still motivating you to keep things the way you want them.
I'm just eager to put this all behind us and give you your reward. Stop reading into things. The danger has passed. You can relax.
Oh, I'm just going to focus on her head at the bottom of the screen.
I'm just keeping myself sharp. I'm not so eager to put my guard down.
I am. I'm on team. Let's put this all behind us. So can we leave already?
Take her with us.
Ugh, fine. You pick up the princess's severed head, its neck stump still oozing bodily fluids. Then make your way back upstairs to the first floor of the cabin.
Did you see that? I could have sworn she moved.
She didn't. She's dead.
But what if she's not?
Are you listening to yourself? Do I need to explain to you why decapitation is lethal? The door to your bountiful reward is right in front of you. All you have to do is open it. You open the cabin door, ready to return to a world saved from certain doom. Only a world saved from certain doom isn't what you find. Instead, what you find is... Wait, no, that's not right.
Ah! He couldn't keep us locked up.
Well played.
Talking heads, free a prisoner. Oh, she's metal. She's metal.
This is the end of the world, isn't it? I always thought I'd at least have time to explain myself before I had to watch it happen. It's already... over? Is he gone?
But we're still here. Maybe it wasn't the end of the world after all. Maybe it was just the end of his.
Thanks for carrying me up here. I had to take it on faith that you would know what to do. I'm glad I was right to trust you. So, this is the outside. Maybe it's just my lack of body, but it's colder than I expected.
Oh.
She's gone. And is that a...
But it feels so...
You're right.
Okay.
Feels too...
And empty cities.
Her body is here. Okay. What are your thoughts on this headless one?
This one is cold and cynical. She has protected herself when others could not. She will make for a clever heart.
Okay,
do not
same
mourn
thing.
Her. She doesn't need to be protected any longer. I will long.
A gratuitous vessel. Bring the prisoner's head to her. Woo! Well, that's the prisoner route done and dusted. Oh, that was metal as fuck. Oh, I just like, I need a minute. Holy shit. That was a really cool ending. I just, holy shit. I'm like, I have chills from that. Like, and not like, I'm like clammy. Oh, okay. Oh boy. I liked it, of course. I figured you might like that. It's metal as fuck, it really is. I'm just squeamish. Okay, so we have adversary, specter, tower, and witch. Oh, we'll deal with the broken, because it means we get to do the tower at least. Let's do it again.
You make your way up. The interior of the cat.
Okay. Enter with the knife.
You take the blade from the table.
Down.
The door to the basement.
Oh. It's been so long since anyone's come down here. I was starting to think they'd forgotten about me.
Not going to kill her.
That giant knife you
used. Drop.
You ignore the trembling in your hands and tight.
And attempt to slay the princess, but give up.
Doubt unfold. Are you serious?
A warning.
If that's what you want.
Oh, shut up, Rabbit. Enter the basement with the knife.
You take the blade from the altar. It would be... The door to the basement creaks. Making your way down the spiral staircases, the princess towers over you,
okay.
Almost glowing in the weak. As if on command, the blade slips from your grasp. It clatters.
Oh, are you still trying to...
Don't tell her why you're here.
You weak-willed buffoon.
Is that so?
The princess closes her eyes.
Know the limits of your privilege, little bird.
I'm not gonna help you end the world.
I see. Perhaps you need another lesson in submitting.
You reach forward and grasp. You can feel a creaking tension between body.
Oh, we'll end this.
It says, and then slay yourself. Let's. I'm doing it at the right time here.
No, you can't just slay yourself. You're perfectly healthy and capable, and all you have to do is ignore her and do what has to be done. The blade and the hand that wields it remain firmly locked in place until you change your mind and decide to do literally anything else.
Look at you quaking against my will. An ant defying a god. It's pointless to resist. In the end, everything submits to oblivion. But you're not the one resisting me, are you? There's something else in there.
I love it when she calls out the narrator.
Is that a person?
Or like she knows.
It used to be a person.
Yeah, no, she's talking about the narrator.
It's something different now. An echo.
Is she talking about you?
Yes.
That's impossible. She's not supposed to be able to interact with me.
You're a small one, aren't you? A shriveling little worm stretched beyond its limits, trying to control things that it can't understand.
Ruth.
No. What are you talking about? I'm just...
I don't care what you are. You're mine.
Sweet.
You bring the blade to your neck. You slice through soft flesh, severing veins and arteries. Your blood flowing freely down your body. It's a painful lesson in obedience, but the pain won't last forever.
No.
When I see you again, you'll free me from my chains and deliver me to the destiny that lies beyond this place.
We will. I promise.
I know you will.
Everything goes dark, and you die.
You're
on a path in the woods, and at the end of that path...
Oh, let me guess. At the end of that path is a cabin.
Excuse me? This is the third time we've been here, and this is hardly a path
Paranoid.
In the woods. It's all big and weird.
Another witness to her radiance. Her hour is soon upon us.
I'm here to keep him in check. I'm sick of prying fingers digging around in our head, and he's making it all too easy for them to get in. This is bad.
Oh, is it now? I hadn't noticed. Do you need a primer, Mr. Amnesiac?
No, I'm quite all right, but if all of you would take a moment to settle down, there's something important I'd like to get across to you before it's too late.
Is it about the princess? We already know all about the princess.
Not to be trusted, that one.
My God, the hero is done. This is the first time I've actually heard him be fucking Dunyan Rings. Like, for real.
No, I mean, yes, it's about the princess, but whatever you think I'm going to say, it's probably not that. You're not to be trusted either.
Look, fine, just out with it already, yeah? But if I hear the words, "You're here to slay her," or "If you don't, it will be the end of the world," you'll have lost speaking privileges.
I love him.
You two are just wasting your time. It's all going to end when we open that cabin door, which means it's already all over. What's the point of dawdling when the end is already written?
Okay, that nonsense he's going on about, that's what we need to talk about. You've been here before, obviously.
So you have met us. Because boy, were you in denial about that last time.
Yeah, that gif is basically what we're doing to the narrator.
No, I haven't met you, but reality is clearly falling apart at the moment, and the only reason that would happen is if you knew things you weren't supposed to know.
What? What the hell are you talking about?
He's talking about those weird marble trees and how wrong everything looks.
Yes, exactly. Whatever you did before gave her far too much power. So you've got to cut it out, get to that cabin and slay her before things get any more out of hand.
We've built a new god, and she is limitless.
Are our thoughts doing that? Make her small, make her small, make her small, make her small. Shit! What if I'm doing it wrong? What if I'm making her even stronger? Do you hear those two with their runaway thoughts? I'm only giving you the sliver of information I'm giving you now because things are already deep in the shitter. This was my last card to play, and it looks like it's already made things worse, so hurry. Cabin, now.
Okay, so now, hold on. I have so many questions.
And right now, you have neither the time nor the mental acuity to handle a single response. It's now or never. But a great and horrible change is already underway. The ground quakes beneath your feet, and you feel an unyielding force pulling at you and your surroundings. The trees start to sway, then crumble, breaking apart as everything is drawn towards the cabin. Even the earth beneath you seems to shift, your feet unable to grip solid ground as you're dragged forward along with everything else.
The end of everything. The beginning of something new. The moment we open that door, she will be free.
Stop believing everything you hear. We just have to get our thoughts in order. We just have to think straight.
Any words of warning?
You already know everything you need to know. As you step forward, the cabin explodes. You're flung backwards, violently slamming into a tree as debris rains down around you.
Yo!
In paralyzed awe and terror as the princess emerges, her body unfurling from some vast space as she stands upright to face you.
Biblically accurate princess.
The world bows to her. The ruined landscape shifts, trees and stone and the ground itself succumbing to her gravity, orbiting her like a great black hole.
Finally, the little bird has set me free. This is always how it was going to end. And this is always how it was going to begin.
There's a loud thunk from the tree behind you as something embeds in its shattered bark. Your pristine blade. It's now or never.
I mean, it says choices are irrelevant, but I'm still curious.
Yeah. Screw all of this, I'm with you. A real god wouldn't need us as part of her plan.
You'll never make it to her. And even if you do, what could you possibly hope to accomplish?
We'll do what we were always supposed to. We'll take this blade
and we'll sink it into her heart.
Look at the way everything's being flung around her. If we just throw ourselves in her direction, I don't know. Maybe it'll work. Maybe none of this is real. Maybe we can do whatever we want to do.
Oh, see, the paranoid's kind of always had it.
With a forceful tug, you yank the blade out from the tree. You close your eyes and take a deep breath.
Oh, it's in stabbing
position.
For
a moment, you can feel everything around you. Like you're a part of everything, and everything is a part of you.
Reverse grip.
And then your eyes open, settling on your target. It's time. You launch yourself towards the princess. You can feel her gravity envelop you, carrying you from the ground into the violent swirl of her orbit.
Even now you define me. Do it, then. Show me what you think it takes to end what's destined to end everything.
Yeah. Do it. Show her.
Why do I feel so cold?
You do not get the chance to slay her, nor will you ever.
Oh, where did she go?
The end of something. Witness your bearer's ascension.
She's gone. Is this the end of the world? Did she end herself?
Is that a mirror? But it feels so
calling us. I don't want to look at us.
Okay. Can we trust you? A mercy.
Whoa!
I am a growing chorus of contradiction.
Yeah, you are.
This one is dominance, a figure capable of bending everything to her will. She will make for a terrifying and divine heart. Do not mourn her, for she would not be able to mourn you. I will be here when it is time.
A godly vessel. Bring me a poth to her. Absolutely, not saying that right. Let's just see what happens if we, like, surrender to Oblivion or whatever. I embrace Oblivion. It's gonna be the same thing either way. I'm just curious. Does she just lift us up?
Empty seat at my side. Join me for a new dawn.
You fool. You can feel her gravity envelop you, carrying you from the ground into the violent swirl of her world.
Why do I feel so?
Oh, the other ending is more metal. The other ending was a lot more metal. Choosing to take the blade. That was a lot more fun. And that is the end of the tower route. So we will be ending it next time by finishing the adversary. The Spectre and the Witch. So I should have 6 left, right? 1, 2. I'm glad I remembered a possum. 3, 4. 5, 6. Let's see how much steam has I have. Does I have? 91 out of 97. Let's go. I've been playing for 18 hours. Over. I've actually been playing for 20.8. Okay. Wow, holy shit. Okay, I'm almost all slayed out too. I'm not like sick of it like I was with Tunic, where I'm like, I'm never gonna look at this game for like another 3 years. But I'm definitely like, okay. Probably so many gruesome ways she can die before I'm starting to be like, all right. Oh, the talking heads one, that one fucked me up. Oh man, I'm still clammy from that one. Tower did help me feel better, but I'm still clammy from that one. Whew. Oh, Utter Wuss likes to play horror games more at 11. Okay. So thank you guys so much. It's gonna be over next time. And then maybe we can talk about the fucking mirror? But yeah, thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it. It might be a shorter one next time, but maybe not with the talking we'll do. Who knows? But yeah, I really appreciate it. Thank you guys so much. And I will see you next time.